Our police are investigating shots fired at a home in Falmouth early this morning. Three adults and a toddler were inside the home at the time. It happened at 407 Route 1, that is right next door to Street Cycles, a well-known motorcycle shop. News 8's Jim Keithley has been on the story all day long, and he joins us now with the details. Jim?
Well, Tracy, the owner of the motorcycle shop also owns that small home that was fired at. He told me a young couple rents the house from him, and he said they just moved in about 6 months ago.
Just after 2 this morning, gunshots rang out in the usually quiet town of Falmouth. Police cars and even the mobile crime unit rushed to the scene and surrounded this little red house at 407 U.S. Route 1. Investigators can be seen through the front door collecting evidence. A canine tracking dog was also brought in. Police say three adults and a toddler were inside at the time. Nobody was hurt. But the question tonight, who fired the shots and why?
We're still trying to determine who really is involved. As far as we know, we've spoken to the residents, and that's it at this point.
The European bakery is just 2 doors away. Heather Adams usually arrives early to start baking. The shooting has rattled her nerves.
To know that there's someone out there, yeah, it's kind of, it makes you nervous.
We noticed several young women and a toddler come and go from the home 12 hours after the shooting was reported. They went to the back side of the house to inspect the bullet holes. The white stickers left by police marked the spot where each shot left a hole in the siding. There were 4 of them. The women did not want to speak with us. But the shooting was the talk of the town today for those who live and work here.
I think things like that don't normally happen in Falmouth, so I don't really know. It's odd, very bizarre.
Now, police told me that investigators have been out all day tracking down leads in the case. They have no new updates as of right now, however. We're live in the studio. Jim Keithley, News 8.